This is for me almost informal. Remember that the important thing that in 2 weeks there are the free FEM days. So I will, this is the reason why I speak about free FEM. And for me, it's quite easy. So the people which helped me to make this talk are Olivier Pironneau, well known, Pierre Jolivet, he does the parallel part. Pierre-Henri Tournier do the parallel part and also the BEM part. Frédéric Nataf do a lot of things in the domain decomposition. Victoria de Leon too. And Gontran Lance and Emmanuel Treva do something on optimization. Okay, so first of all, I apologize because my English are not so good. So I'm quite sure I put French word in my presentation, but don't. If you understand French, it's good. If you don't understand, please stop me and say, "Oh, what did you say?" So I do an introduction. I speak a little bit about mesh adaptation, some example, and after two, almost two example. I try to understand how snakes swim in the water, and I try to do a small modelization with FreeFEM and IPOPT, so with optimization, because what is the best form of the snake to do swimming? And at the end, if I have time, I speak about brain stroke imagery to see if it's possible to visualize in the brain AVC. So in English, it's CVH. So it's cerebral vascular problem. Okay, so the introduction. So what is FreeFEM? First of all, FreeFEM, it's a free software to solve PDE, so partial differential equation, now in R2, R3, or on curve and surface with finite element. And we use a specific domain language, so DSL, to set and control the problem. And this language allows to do rapidly a specification of the PDE through the variational form. And in fact, if your problem is linear, it is quite easy, and you can write your own script. Of course, you have tools to do mesh generation, mesh adaptation. You can try to move, do something on moving domain, compute eigenvalue, etc., etc. And by the way, FreeFEM is a tool to play with abstract forms, so linear and bilinear, on finite element space, and also with interpolation error. Remember, I'm a mathematician. So my point of view is really to make software to simplify the mathematical coding of equation on a computer. So it's a freeware. They run on Mac because I'm almost Mac addict, on Unix, and also Windows. And you can do parallel with MPI. Thank you to Antoine Leharic. They do a version we run on cell phone. You have so the FreeFEM days in 2 weeks at Sorbonne University. The inscription are free. You can come or you can follow by Zoom. And some information. One of the biggest problems solved by FreeFEM is 22 billion of unknown in 200 seconds on 12,000 processors. And so, thank you to Pierre Jolivet. So, a little bit of history. Before was Modulef, and as you see, FreeFM exists from almost 1987 and until now, so it's quite old software. I think some person in the some auditor are not born when FreeFM start. Okay, so the main characteristic, so it's, I will speak about finite elements. So you have a lot of type of finite elements, classical, P1, P2, discontinuous, c'est Ravier-Thomas, Brezzi, Douglas-Marini, edge element or Nedelec element. You can build vectorial element by composition of scalar element. You have also mini element. So you can add, it's not too difficult to add a finite element, but it's not so simple too. You have, of course, an automatic interpolation of data from a mesh to another with possibility to construct the matrices. So a finite element function can be viewed as a function of x, y in 2D or if y, z in 3D, or they can be viewed as an array of the degree of freedom. You can define the problem or real or complex value through the variational form, and you can of course have access to vector and matrices. You can do discontinuous Galerkin formulation. You have almost all the good linear solver, sparse linear solver implement in FreeFM. You can compute eigenvalue with RPAC or SLEPC if you want to do parallel. You have also online graphics, so it's very light, but of course you can use more things with ParaView, for example, to have pretty results. But the graphic for me is sufficient just to make paper. You have so the JavaScript version. I can maybe try to show you the JavaScript version. J'ai compris. Here, you have the JavaScript. You can go to an example and you can run. And here it's run entrée. And you have the graphic. You can play with that. It is quite simple. Okay. You can, in 2D, define the boundary through your analytical description, but you have to do the intersection of boundary in 2D by hand. You have, of course, access to automatic mesh generator based on Delaunay-Voronoi algorithm, because I spent a lot of time to build this kind of algorithm when I'm young. You can, of course, load and save meshes. You can do mesh adaptation, and you can make link with other software, such as ParaView, GMSH, etc., Gnuplot. You can add dynamic linking things to add plugin in FreeFM. You have a full MPI interface, and you can do also non-linear optimization, and a very good tool, it's called IPOPT. It is interior point optimization. You can do also stochastic optimization, but I'm really not a specialist. And you have a lot of examples. Okay. What they are in progress, so I just go fast about that. The version is now 4.11. If you want to download from the source, you can do this fee. You can use Git to clone the version. I will try to do mesh intersection to get conservative formulation in 2D. Too hard, and so I stop this part. I try to make fast interpolation in surface and line mesh. It's almost done. It's not so fast, but it works. The new graphic interface in progress but not fast enough for me. So you have a lot of finite element on curve and surface, it seems okay. You have now access to Boundary Elements method, the first version, and for more details, see Xavier Claes and Pierre-Henri Tournier. So now it's very good. You have Galerkin discontinuous in 3D on surface and curve. You have a first version. I rewrite all the kernel for sparse matrices. That is done. Now we try to make coupling with finite element and surface finite element and Boundary elements, which is in progress. I think I want to rewrite the kernel of RIFM to do isoparametric finite element, but in future, I like to make a debugger, but it is quite hard to do, so wait and see. And now we try to have more general problem with the new matrix system. This is in progress with Jacques Maurice and also Pierre-Henri Tournier. An OpenMP interface will be quite good, but today not. I think I will add, if I have time, and you have a quadruple precision floating type in FreeFM, but this is just a version from Atsushi Suzuki, and it's really tricky things. Okay, so this is almost the end of the intersection, the introduction, sorry, and I want to speak about what is a weak form. So I want to solve my Laplace equation in weak form. So first of all, I do this example in Houston, the 1st April, four. Sorry, this is not the COVID. This is just because it's called in France. So I want to solve a problem in a domain of RD with D equal two or three. And my Boundary is cut in two parts, gamma 2 and gamma E. Gamma 2, it's the place where I put the solution equal 2 on gamma 2. And in gamma exterior, I put the normal derivative are equal to 0. And so I want to solve minus delta U equal 1 in omega, and U equal 2 on gamma 2, and the UDN equal 0. So if I denote VG, the space of function in H1, so that V on gamma 2 are equal to G, so G can be 0 or 2 here. The basic formulation will be find u in V2, so that because I take this function and multiply by a test function V and integrate by part, so I take the integral of grad u, grad V, sorry, equal the integral of 1 V plus the green term, it's with the green formula, so it makes the color is good corresponding to the type of the integral. It's a good joke in English. In French, it's not so good. du, dn, v. And of course, the green term disappear. Why? Because v, because you are known on gamma 2, I have to take no test function on gamma 2. So V are equal to 0 on gamma 2 because I want to have a square problem. And in the other part, in gamma O, du, dn are equal to 0. So the green term disappear. What is the fundamental remark on that? This equation 2 corresponding to the minimization of the energy G of U. And this is Euler-Lagrange equation corresponding to the minimization of G on space V2. So, and the magic idea of the finite element is just replace the space V0 or VG by a finite element space. And the FreeFM code will be find the mesh, define the finite element space, define u and v are in a finite element space, define the gradient, and I solve the Laplace UV. I choose a solver, but if you don't choose a solver, they use a default solver, and you say grad U prime, grad V, because grad is a vector in column, so grad U prime become a row vector, multiply by a column vector, you get a scalar product, minus delta in 3D 1V, and I say on gamma 2, I say U equal 2, and I plot. So remark, in 3D, it's a little bit tricky because the boundary, I want to solve that on a fish. The boundary of the fish are connex, so I don't have two connex components, so I put a sphere inside my domain. But this is just technical. Okay, so this is my example. 1st April 2004 in Houston. So this is Houston fish. I define my space. I define the gradient. In 2D, you have just two components. And I solve. And you get the result. Just a remark, the computer compute. This is not a movie. As you see, it is quite fast. C'est quoi ce truc-là? Il y a des gens qui ont écrit sur la vidéo. Ouais. This is not important. Okay, and you can see the mesh. Theoretically, non, on ne voit pas le mesh. Ah, pourquoi on ne voit pas le mesh, M? Ah, si. And you equal, you can see the mesh here. I don't know. Yeah, you can see the mesh. Il y a un nouveau qui est rentré dans la salle. Hop. Voilà. The same in 3D. So it's a little bit more tricky. I get the mesh of the fish. Here. Thanks to Eric Saltel, he make a huge database of surface mesh long time ago when I am at INRIA, and I build a mesh of the sphere here, and I put the sphere inside my my fish, and I plot the mesh, and after I fill the surface mesh with tetrahedrons, and I solve my problem. This is the same. Here you see the ball. So I put two on the ball and the UDN on all the other part. Sorry, I try. Okay. C, B, E, M. C'est, ça marche, non? And you see the solution on the skin. And if you make a cut, you have the solution inside the fish. And here, you get the same thing. So with FreeFM, it's quite easy to solve linear PDEs with almost all finite elements. Now, if you want to do more amazing things, you can try to solve Laplace-Beltrami problem, so on a torus. So this is, I want to compute eigenvalue of Laplace-Beltrami, but unfortunately, because I am at discrete level, the basic function on the surface are constant in a normal direction, so the tangential gradient are exactly the gradient. So in fact, here, this is just a Laplace operator if you just change a finite element. Now you have just a little problem to have the representation. I want to define the normal of the surface, which are defined at each vertices, so I want to have a P1 normal. So to do that, I just make L2 projection of my true normal to the P1 normal. I'm sorry, this is a little bit technical. Ça marche? Oui. So here the scripts are more bigger. Here I build the mesh. I define the gradient. I define my matrices. Here I define the normal in P1. So just this is just for the graphic. I compute the eigenvalue. And now I move the mesh in the direction of the normal for any solution of that to see something. And I try to launch this. Here you see the torus. First eigenvalue, second, etc. You see, just for the fun. Okay, mesh adaptation. I see I'm a little bit late, so I skip that. So the major idea of the mesh adaptation is to introduce metrics. So a metric is M to change the way to compute the length of the curve. And it's almost say I put a deformation and I compute the distance in the after the deformation and M corresponding to the derivative of the deformation. And with that, I can do mesh adaptation, which are almost optimal. For example, if I want to build the optimal mesh to represent the function U and V, here you have the example of what you can do with that. And the idea is the metric in this case will be almost the mixture between the Hessian, so the second derivative of U, and the second derivative of V. So I skip that. In 2D, if you want to use, ça a marché ça? Okay. If you want to use that, you get mesh adaptation. And if you know a little bit in finite element, you know you have singularity on the corner. And the mesh are completely okay with the singularity. You have the good ratio in the mesh size with that. And even for P1, you see you have anisotropy on the mesh. So the mesh are not completely equilateral. Okay. You can build metric with other norm. So I give the slide just for the fun. You can do the same now in 3D with the software called MMG 3D and the version 5. And I try to show you that. So it's almost the same problem that in 2D. Here you have a cube where I remove a small cube and you have three singular edges. And you see here. And you see the mesh are clearly refined in this with anisotropy meshes because here the singularity, here you have less singularity in this direction compared to the normal direction. So you can really do amazing things with FreeFrame. This is just advertising. So now go to example. First of all, I want to make something with Stokes' problem to show you we've not with vectorial problem. So the basic Stokes' problem is find the velocity u and the pressure p field in the domain omega, and you have minus Laplace u plus grad p equals zero in omega. Divergence of u equals zero in omega, and u on gamma is given. So if you have that, you have the variational form is given by this equation, integral of grad u, grad v minus p, dv minus q, dv equals zero. But in this formulation, the pressure are defined through a constant. So this is the reason why Q is in space L2 with no constant, so at mean value equal zero. But the problem, this constraint is not, it is a non-local constraint because it means the mean value are zero. So if you put value in somewhere, you have to change all the function everywhere to remove the constant. So, but you know, big principle in mathematical numerical analysis, that generally the problem must be well posed at the Hadamard sense. I think it's Hadamard. I'm not completely sure about Hadamard, but and it means if I make a small perturbation on my equation, the solution will be closed. If, of course, my my problem is well posed. Stokes is well posed, and at discrete level, my problem is also well posed. So I can make a small modification, and I put a small regularization, minus integral of epsilon pq here, where epsilon are, in this case, 10 at the power minus 10, so it's very small. And here, if you do that, you build the solution Q so that the pressure P will be at mean value zero. And it's quite easy to add this constraint in free frame. Otherwise, when I'm a student, the people say you have to fix the pressure in one point, and it's not so easy to fix the pressure in one point of the mesh. So I prefer really this way to do this. So here you have the Stokes equation in 3D. So I compute, I put the gradient here, and I put Stokes on cavity, and here you get the solution on a mesh, I don't know, it's 10 by 10 or 8 by 8. Not too big, but not too bad, so you can solve Stokes' problem with no difficulty. And just for now I put Navier-Stokes. This is Navier-Stokes. No, this is Stokes also in curve domain. Ah, c'est bien ça. Ah, and this is, I want to see the equation. So here it's more clever. I compute Navier-Stokes on the aorta to compute the flow of blood in complex object. Here, the computer compute. So I make no movie. This is really amazing. The formulation here, it's more complex because I use a Kawachabar algorithm. And the Kawachabar algorithm, it's a very old algorithm because it was created when I'm student. So by EDF. And the major idea is you take Uzawa method. Of course, Uzawa, it's a fixed point method. So first of all, rather to make a fixed point, you use conjugate gradient to solve because the problem is symmetric definite negative, but it's the same things. You have just to solve, put minus the problem to get positive. And after that, you build a preconditioner, and the preconditioner, it just say when you are in a Fourier space, all the operator divergence Laplace commute except with the boundary condition. And with that, you can build a good preconditioner. Okay, so now, almost my last example, I think I skip the very last because it is 39, I have 10 minutes. The optimization tools, and I want to do snake swimming. At the beginning, I do this with Gontran Lanz and Emmanuel Trella for the thesis of Gontran Lanz, and we try to make a paper, a small book, to explain how to do optimization with FreeFM. We try to make a first example. So IP-OPT optimization is a software which are fully interfaced with FreeFM. And to solve this problem of minimization, find the argument minimum of functional F with a constraint on the unknown U, and you have also constraint on some function. So it's basic algorithm, and it's quite a good thing. Of course, to use IP-OPT, you must know F, the derivative of F, the derivative of the constraint, and possibly the second derivative of F. It is a little bit tricky, but it's really fast and good algorithm. So the snake swimming. So first of all, I want to understand why a snake moves in a water. So first of all, I give you a small movie. I'm sorry, because you are a place where you have almost very few water because you have desert and sun, but so here you see. C'est marrant, il y a du son sur mon film. Okay, here you see you have like a sinusoid movement, but I want to go fast and I want to see if it's possible to do everything in 2D. And I want also to do things with no movement because, sorry, when you do movement, it's more complex to code. So I do no movement. So first of all, I will suppose the swimming speed are constant in time and are sine or cosine. And I think that the snake will be infinite in 2D. And so it is a line like this. And there are a movement in x. So I think y will be f of x of vt, or v are the speed of the snake. Okay, and of course, I think everything will be periodic at the end. So f of zero are equal to f of l and are equal to zero. And we are the translation speed. So just to see there are movement, I make a crazy script, very difficult. I show you the sign. We are moving with a speed t. You see here, you see the movement. And the velocity are equal to one. So it means that the velocity go from left to right. Be careful, I'm dyslexic. But when you see the speed, they go to right to left. It's normal. It's exactly what you are in a train. And you see the... Sorry. The movement are inverse when you change a framework. Okay. So this is first. So... I will just take the upper part for symmetry reason. And in a snake frame, the movement, there are no movement. Okay? But of course, you have speed and a boundary, so you have to be careful. And I make the assumption that the movement here are vertical. This is not exactly, because the snake are almost inextensible. I'm sorry, I do that in French. And clearly that the length of the curve here will be constant in time. But you are moving, you are make moving. So I have do a small computation just before. I compute the primitive of the length is given by this formula. And here you have the line, and as you see, the line are very close to a straight line. So it means that they are very close to no tangents movement when you are movement. Okay. I'm sorry for that. It is a little bit tricky. So now I can try to solve that. So in summary, I have three frame: the frame of the snake, the frame of the computation, so it move at the speed v zero, because the snake move. Now in the this frame RC, there are no movement, and there are also the frame of the experiment, because the snake move in the experiment frame, and in fact is given by the speed of the water at the infinity, because I suppose that the domain are infinite. So in the reference frame, the speed of my boundary are given by f in y direction, f of x0 plus v, and I have only speed on direction v, so x0. So my this is a curve of my stake, and now the speed of the deformation will be the derivative of that. So it's zero in x, and the derivative of this function in t, so it's v f prime of. And you can notice that the velocity in frame zero are equal to the velocity in frame c minus vc, velocity of my movement. And the green term I have to put my integral to make a small velocity here due to the fact that the snake are inextensible. But I'm lazy, so I don't do. And the results are quite good. So now, if I want to continue the modelization, I do Navier-Stokes. And Navier-Stokes are stable with change of frame in a Galilean framework. So otherwise, the equation will be the same in RC and in R0. So don't care. So I put Navier-Stokes. I get my solution. But what is magic that is now in frame RC? I have no movement. So it's quite easy to compute. Okay, so I get the solution, and now I want to see what's happened. So I put a mesh, quite small, and I show you. So this is a mesh. Here in the bottom, you have a piece of snake, and you have movement vertical. Due to the movement. Remember, the movement are almost the velocity times the derivative of the function f. The function f are a sine. So here the derivative are negative. Here the derivative are positive. And if the velocity are positive, so here the velocity are like this, here are like this. And so you get a rotation like this. So as you see, the velocity are negative, V. So here it's inverse, but don't care, I'm dyslexic. So if you see, this small vortices give you a flow, go from left to right. And this explains why when you have this transform a vertical movement on horizontal movement, in fact, at the mechanical level. Okay. And now, if I make the change of framework, I go in the framework of the snake, the velocity must be tangent to the snake. So I show the velocity, and you see the velocity will be really tangent to the snake here. So everything seems okay. I make no big bug in modelization. Okay. So now I want to I want to do the variational formulation of the optimal problem, because in fact my optimal problem is find the shape of the snake so that the velocity at the infinity are maximum. Alors, remark, at the infinity, I say I have no forces. So I said the pressure are the no forces means the pressure are almost given at the infinity. So in fact, in this case, the pressure are not defined for a constant. This is due to boundary condition at the infinity. And I solve now the velocity in space H1 periodic, where with the periodicity u in x are equal to u in x plus l, where l is the size of my domain, with homogeneous boundary condition in gamma s, so in gamma snake. And I want to solve this thing, so everything is okay. There are really no problem. C'est quoi? C'est le même que l'autre, je pense. I think this is exactly the same problem as you see before. Now my optimization is find the best neck shape to maximize the velocity generated by the form of my snake. Few remarks. I spent with the student almost 6 months to do that, and I make completely crazy things. I think that the best shape will be a snow tooth shape. So for the no good English speaker, c'est une forme en dents de scie. And I think also this snow tooth shape will be non-symmetric. And in fact, the shape can be, because I think if the shape are symmetric, you get no movement. But when you see that why the rotation are done, it's not due to the symmetry. And now I have to impose a constant volume. So in fact, the integral of f will be zero. And clearly, if g of f grow, if the norm of f grow, so I have to put constraint. And in fact, I put constraint on a curvature and also on derivative. And I use IPOP. So Gontran-Lanz compute the derivative of this functional, and you get the code. I give you the code with the script if you want to play. So here, you get the solution, and here I put a limitation. Here I have three parameters, the bound on F, the bound on the derivative, and the bound on the curvature. So if I put 30, I think I put no bound on the curvature to see what's happened. As you see the dancy appear. So sorry, I missed the name in English. Okay, so it's really really amazing to understand what's happened. So in fact, the real limitation is the curvature. And of course, you can also bound the derivative and you have all the script. So as you see, it's not so long. It's 200 lines. So I re-put. Okay, il est quelle heure?
C'est la bonne heure. Là, le temps est terminé, mais bon, tu peux prendre...
Okay, non, but it's... Okay. So this is 2D example. In the next, we have to explain how to make imagery to the brain imagery to find stroke. So remember, you have two kind of stroke, ischemic. So it means that you have something in the blood. We block the blood somewhere. So a caillot, and so if you have that, the way to solve the problem is put in French du débouchant, and if it's hemorrhagic, you have something where the blood get outside the arteries, and so you have to put du bouchon, pour parler français, okay? So, and it's very important because you can save the people if you are able to put the correct medicine in half an hour. After a while, it will be really difficult to save the people. So the idea is to try to make that in the ambulance. As you see, that my English is very bad. And we are a project where we try to use this kind of antenna to get the measurement of the brain. So the equation are almost mathematical, so it's a classical problem. And I want to solve an inverse problem to rebuild the permittivity of the tissue. And with the permittivity of the tissue, I'm able to see what's happened in the brain. And here you have the experiment, and you can do that. So here it's the correct things. And here you put a piece where blood here, so they change the permittivity. And in the reconstruct image, you see here, compare, you see these things. And if you put a more bigger things, you see really. And what is really important, so it's you can, we are able to build this image on almost 300 seconds, so almost 5 minutes. And this is really important because you don't put the people in EMR or in PET scan, and you can do that a lot of in continuous way, so you can see the movement. And that's the last things I want to say with FreeFem. And in conclusion, FreeFem, it's a really good tools to solve non-standard PDEs in 2D and 3D. With surface, you can try domain decomposition and new algorithm. In future, you can to try to add better graphics, better mesh adaptation, but this is almost done. And we try to also automate the parallel tools and add integral methods with Jacques Maurice and Xavier Claes and Pierre-Henri Tournier. And with Georges Sadaka, we try also to make finite volume to the future. And so, merci pour tout.
Thank you, Frédéric. I will try to reactivate the microphone.
Okay.
Is there some questions? And okay. Okay, I have a first question. You said that the results that we see on the screen are in real time, then the computations are made on your computer?
Yeah. You want to know which computer I have?
Yes.
So I have a MacBook Pro. I can show you that. Apropos de ce Mac.
Okay.
I have a MacBook Pro with the M1 hardware and with the 32 gigaoctet gigabyte of RAM.
Okay.
This is not the last version, it's 1 year old.
Okay.
And really compare to Intel processor, you have a speed up of 2 on FreeFM.
Okay.
With the i7 or i9 processor. But it's quite really fast machine.
Okay, I see, because with 3D results, it's very impressive, yes. Is there a question in the audience? Yes, Martial? Go on, you can reactivate your microphone. Martial, you can ask your question, but activate. Okay.
Good evening.
Okay. Yes, go on.
Yes, thank you very much for this wonderful presentation. I study the similar problem, particularly on the curve. For example, to compute, to solve the Laplace equation on the sphere, on the torus, and on the cube skin.
Yeah.
Using another tools, like called Salome.
Yeah.
The solver lab developed in the, that numerical tools for develop in CEA Paris-Saclay. It is my first time to study free frame.
Yeah.
Yes, it is welcome. And I'm interested by the future work, for example, Bumo graphic with VTK, because our Salome use something like VTK to visualize the solution. We use the ParaView 2.
Yeah.
I would like to understand how we can do it with Salome or another numerical tools.
So here it's quite take a long time to give you an answer, but today the way it saves the data, and you can save the data in VTK form, in VTK file, and after you can use VTK to watch to see your graphics. But yes. I'm not a specialist of ParaView. So my colleague used ParaView to see the graphics. And it's very useful in parallel.
You can do ParaView, yeah.
Because you can have a decomposition of your mesh in parallel with the subdomain and the whole things with ParaView. But I'm really not a specialist. Yeah, I show you all the graphic with the built-in FreeFM graphic, and remember the FreeFM graphic are done by me and my student when I teach, and it's less than 200 lines of C++. So it's very, very tiny things.
All right.
Okay, thank you for your question. Is there another question?
Yes.
Yes, Michel,
I have a couple of questions.
Okay, go on.
Very interesting. I think I'll probably be using FreeFM now that I know so much about it. I have a question on the optimization part. First is, you said that we have to introduce the derivatives of the function and the constraints. Does that mean that there is no internal or built-in calculation derivatives, like numerically numeric approximations of the derivative? Is there such?
With a long time ago, maybe 10 years or more than maybe 15 years ago, we tried to make automatic differential part in FreeFM. But unfortunately, FreeFM become unstable and I remove this feature. So I have an idea to do that, but it's not so simple. So, and generally, the major difficulty is when you do a moving mesh, as I do with my snake, it is really difficult to derive automatically the functional through the derivative of the boundary. So, and this is the reason why it's become unstable. And one other difficulty in this example, if you go back to the object, the movement, the boundary condition are f prime, the derivative of my functional.
Mm-hmm.
So f, of course, at the end, it will be a finite element, p1. And f prime, it will be p0. And I want to put a movement which are also p1. So I have to make reinterpolation to change function from p0 to p1. So and this is really tricky stuff, in fact.
Yeah.
So it is really not so simple to put completely automatic differential. Yeah. So today, this is the reason why you make a small book on optimization. It's I try to explain how to do automatic differential by hand. And so when you do that, you understand where are the trouble.
Yeah.
And the other thing is, for me, I have a strong difficulty with adjoint method.
Mm-hmm.
I know what is it, but for me, compute the adjoint is some part of magic. That's.
Yeah. If I may, my other question is on the optimization problem itself. It looks like it's a general problem, so I suspect that the algorithm for solving the problem will also be general. So if I have a specific application with special structure, such as conic program or convex program.
Yes, of course, you can make convex optimization, but today in FreeFM, remember, there are a lot of algorithms, and remember, the team of FreeFM are quite small because we are almost 4 developers. So it's very few, the team are very small. So we reuse a lot of things from the web. Mm-hmm. So if you get a good software for your case, and you think it was really interesting to add to FreeFM, of course we can try to add. But you have to make the job to say, this is a good software, my problem is this, and I can solve this kind of problem with this software.
Yeah.
If it's general enough, we try to add. But of course, it must take 6 months.
And, yeah.
But it should be not instantaneous.
Yeah. It should be quite easy to link, to use an external algorithm, of course. I suppose.
I can say yes and no.
Uh-huh.
The problem is when you want to link with external library, you have to make what you say in French, moulinette, to mm-hmm. transform internal data structure of FreeFM on internal data structure of the library.
Mm-hmm.
And this can be simple or very, very hard. It depends strongly of what do your external library.
Merci. Thank you.
Thank you, Hichem. Is there other questions? I have another question about then in FreeFM, we know that we can do volumic finite elements or boundary element methods.
Yeah.
And the boundary element method, we have a double integration on one boundary.
Yeah.
If we use a method that is an alternative to integral equation, you know it, the method developed by Lenoir and Jamy, and that we can find in the software XLife++, we have a double integration, but on two different boundaries. Is it possible on free?
I think it's possible, but if you want to be sure, ask Pierre-Henri Tournier or Xavier Kless. But I think yes, because when you try to reconstruct the solution, you have to make a double integral on two domains.
Okay, and I ask you the question because there is a community that use FreeFM++ and they are interested by this method. And then it's a possible
the solution best
for them. They don't use, they don't want to use another software.
Okay, so what I have to say, the best way is ask a question in a community part of FreeFM. I can show you where is it on a website. And I send a mail to the major developer to say if it's possible or not. Okay. I'm really not a specialist on the BEM part.
Okay.
You know that from this maybe five years ago, I know almost everything in FreeFM.
Sorry? Now, 5 years ago, you?
5 years ago, I know all FreeFM, all things are inside FreeFM.
Ah, okay.
Now it's not true.
Okay.
I'm, what you say in French, I'm dépassé.
Okay. Then it means that there is an evolution in FreeFM.
Yeah. I know a lot of things, but not all.
Okay. Is there other questions? No questions? Okay. If there is no other question, I want to thank again Frédéric Escht for this very beautiful talk and for accepting our invitation. Thank you, Frédéric, and I hope we can see you again.
Yeah. So thank you,
Steve,
and see you next time in next place.
I hope so. Merci beaucoup. Merci.
So remember, there are the FreeFM days, and you can go in. In the website and just to see, to watch what they are. The program are not completely finished, but generally in the morning you have presentation and the afternoon you have tutorials. So, mm-hmm. And the tutorial can be open. So.
And also online or only?
Also online.
Ah, okay, okay.
Ah, bon.
Okay, okay. Okay.
So for the tutorial online, I think it will be more difficult, but we try to do something.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, Frédéric. And keep in touch. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Well, I will wait for the slides.
Okay. So I make a zip and I.